James, recently, the makers of Fortnite, Epic Games, tried to circumvent Apple's 30% revenue cut. Apple, of course, and Google responded by kicking them out of the App Store, and Epic responding by, I guess, suing Apple and Google, saying that they have the monopoly when it comes to app stores. What's at stake here?
Well, basically, for as long as the App Store has existed on the iPhone, Apple has insisted that all payments for digital goods must go through their payment system. And Apple takes basically 30% of the revenue right off the top. And for basically as long as this has been the case, developers have grumbled about it. They don't like paying that kind of money to Apple. It is a big, big percentage. But in the last few months, especially, there has been sort of mounting pressure for Apple to revisit this. And there's been a lot of push to basically make this an antitrust issue, accusing Apple and, to a lesser extent, Google of having a monopoly and abusing that power by just taking this cut. So what Epic Games did last week is that without the permission of Apple, they pushed an update to Fortnite, which is this wildly popular game that has 250 million some odd users, allowing those users to pay Epic Games directly for in-app purchases, as opposed to going through the Apple payment system. Later that same day, Fortnite was kicked out of the App Store. After that, there was this really funny video that Epic called 1980 Fortnite, which was sort of a riff on this old Super Bowl ad from the 1980s, a woman running through like a dystopian future and smashing a screen with like Big Brother on it. And back in the 1980s, this was sort of Apple as the scrappy underdog taking on big companies like IBM. Now, Fortnite is basically saying that Apple is the big monopolist and they're trying to break that cycle. They're not the only one talking about this. And this case has real implications for what software you can put on your phone and basically the economics of computing in 2020.
How does this play out, or how does it look from either side? I mean, you have Epic going up against this behemoth, if you will. And on the other side, you have companies like Apple and Google who've been fighting against being anti-competitive. So explain both sides to us.
So the background here that is worth noting is that there was a similar controversy to this with an email app called Hey. It was sort of a new kind of email service. It was, I think, $100 annual subscription fee. And they sort of, this happened in June, and they were parsing like the specific rules of the App Store and trying to get around this 30% cut thing. And they got in a big public fight with Apple. It got kind of messy. Apple sort of backed down on that. Then in July, the CEOs of the four largest tech companies in the world, Apple, Facebook, Amazon, and Google, all wound up in front of Congress. And the US government is doing a lot of scrutiny about these companies being monopolists. So then when Fortnite sort of starts pushing back on this 30% cut and gets kicked out of the App Store, that launched this whole thing. Apple says basically, we run the App Store and we provide a bunch of services and we deserve to get paid for those things. Apple does app review and basically makes sure that every app that's in the store is safe. You're not downloading any sketchy malware or things that are going to compromise your device. And those are things you have to worry about if you just download software for your computer over the internet. There are sort of scary viruses and malware out there, but that is pretty much kept out of the App Store. And that is how Apple justifies taking this cut. The other side of it is companies basically say that mobile computing, the smartphones we all carry around in our pocket, are basically the future of modern computers. They are like Apple laptops and desktops were in the past, and people should be able to install whatever software they want on it. And one company shouldn't just get to say, we get to take a 30% cut of everything. Now, what's really important here is that there has since been an escalation in this case. Just on Monday, Apple is now threatening to kick Epic Games out of its Apple Developer Program, which will cut the company off from all of the developer tools that Apple makes available, not just for developing on iOS for smartphones, but also for developing on desktop computers. And why this is really important is because Epic Games also makes something called the Unreal Engine, which is this incredibly powerful, widely used, it's almost like an operating system for any sort of program that is using 3D graphics. So lots and lots of other games license the Unreal Engine and use that to make their games. Everything from like all of the graphics that were in The Mandalorian, the TV show that was wildly popular on Disney Plus, those all use the Unreal Engine for photorealistic computer-generated graphics in that TV show. So by cutting Epic off from using any of Apple's developer tools, you're potentially threatening this much broader ecosystem of computer programs and services and basically Epic's games' whole business. So there is a bigger thing going on here of essentially who owns the software, who controls these computer systems, and who is allowed to do what on the devices that you own.
Indulge us here for a moment. If they win, companies like Apple, like Google, they would then have to retool their business model and these apps. And they would essentially be catering strictly to the developers. Is this something that could potentially happen? I understand it's speculative.
Well, honestly, I have no idea how this is going to play out. And especially the court case is the sort of thing that could take years and years and years to work its way through the legal system. When people talk about these kinds of monopolies, there is talk about like breaking Apple up, like spinning the app store off into a completely separate company so that the company that makes the phones isn't also the company that runs the app store. So there isn't that conflict of interest. Because another part of this story is that Apple has its own game service. Apple has a product called Apple Arcade where you pay a subscription fee and you get access to games. Of course, Apple doesn't have to pay itself the 30% cut. So it has a huge advantage on that front. Whether these antitrust concerns play out in terms of courts or the government breaking up these companies or issuing court orders that say, hey, you can't take a 30% cut anymore, you have to take a 5% or 10% cut, it is really difficult to see how all of this plays out, but it does seem to indicate that there is an enormous amount of power being built up in these two mobile operating system platforms, Apple especially because it's a very locked down platform, but also the Google Android ecosystem. The Epic Games is suing Google as well over this. And so how this all plays out and these antitrust concerns really could shape this whole landscape in ways that I really can't predict.